your eyes, focus your entire attention on your breath. Just feel the breath coming into your nostrils and the breath going out. That's it. That is what we need to do for an hour now. And you know, it's not even a breathing exercise. It's not like you try to control the breath and you can fail.
Yeah.
It's not like somebody told you, you must breathe through the right nostril. Mm-hmm. If you breathe through the left nostril, you're a failure in meditation. No, it was just note, is it now coming in or is it now going out? And I was absolutely struck by the fact that I couldn't do it for more than 10 seconds before my mind would just wander off to some memory, some fantasy, some worry. And for 5 minutes, I would roll in that before remembering, oh, I need to observe my breath. And within a very short time, I understood something that I didn't understand after years in university and reading books, which is that I have almost no control over my mind, and I know very, very little about what's actually happening within me, within my mind. And this was a very shocking and humbling experience, but it kind of opened the way to a completely new kind of investigation and practice, which is not based on reading and writing and things like that, but really on just, you know, you just directly observe what is happening. The key idea is, it goes back to what we discussed earlier of stories and fictions, that the mind is like a factory which constantly manufactures stories. And these stories come between me and the world. Most of what I see in life, when I look at US politics, when I look at the global economy, when I look at my own body, most of what I see is the stories generated by my own mind. They are just overpowering. And the key instruction of this kind of meditation, there are many kinds of meditation, but this kind of Vipassana, the key instruction is forget about, let go of all these stories. Just try to observe what is actually happening right now. If you can't observe the breath coming in and out of your nostrils because your mind is too busy, involved in some story, how do you expect to understand US politics without your own stories getting in the way? And this, what connects me back to my job as a historian, you know, when I meditate, I don't have any historical insights. I don't think, at least hopefully, I don't think about the Roman Empire or whatever, but it trains the mind to develop this ability to put aside the stories that I generate and thereby have a clearer vision of whatever it is I'm investigating.
And do you...